Good morning, students. Welcome to today's biology class. This is the last video lesson of your chapter number 1, plant life. In the last video lesson, we have read about fruit, parts of fruits, and dry and fleshy fruits. Okay. In this video lesson, we are going to read about seed, parts of a seed, then what is germination. Okay. So, let us talk about seed first. What is seed? Seed is a fertilized and ripened ovule. Okay. I have told you that when I am teaching you fruit, in that video, I have told you that fruits develop from the ovaries and seeds are developed from the ovules. Okay. So, seed is a fertilized and ripened ovule. Okay. This seed, it contains an embryo. See here, this is a seed. Inside the seed is present an embryo, or you can say it as future plant, because embryo grows into future plant. Okay. Along with that, seed also contain food which provide nourishment to the developing embryo. Okay. Then these seeds, when the favorable conditions came, okay, these seeds undergoes germination and give rise to young plants, or you can say baby plants. These young plants or baby plants are called seedlings. And after that, I'll tell you about parts of a seed. Okay. So, look here in this diagram, this small plant, this young plant, it is known as seedling. Okay. And the part which grows downward, it will give rise to root. That I will explain you when I'll teach you the structure of seed. First of all, in general, seed is a ripened and fertilized ovule which contains embryo and stored food for the embryo. Okay. And this seed, when favorable condition came, develop into young plants called as seedlings. Now, the next topic is parts of a seed. A seed basically, or you can say generally, a seed consists of following parts. First is seed coat, that is the outermost part of the seed. Then embryo. Embryo means the future plant. Okay. And the third one is cotyledon. I'll explain you when I'll show you the diagram. But just remember the parts of a seed. And the last one is endosperm. Okay. So what are the parts of a seed? Seed coat, embryo, cotyledon, and endosperm. Now, look here in this diagram. This diagram shows two types of seed. Okay. I'll explain you this parts of seed with the help of this seed, which is a dicot seed. I'll explain you what are dicot and monocot also. But this is a dicot seed, and I'll explain you the parts of a seed with the help of this diagram. So let us start with the first part, which is seed coat. And all the parts are present in all the different types of seeds. Okay. Then let us talk about the first part, seed coat. See, this outer hard covering, here also this yellow outer hard covering of the seed is known as seed coat. This seed coat is also called as testa. Okay. In biology, the seed coat is known as testa. And the function of the seed coat is to provide protection to the seed. This seed coat is porous in nature and it absorbs water and becomes soft. Okay. And when it absorbs water and becomes soft, then it can be easily removed after absorption of water. And this will help during the process of germination. Okay. When the favorable condition means when there is availability of the water, this seed coat, okay, it absorbs water, clear, and it becomes soft. And as it becomes soft, then this hard covering is removed easily. Okay. Then the second part is embryo. Okay. This is the embryo or embryonic root or stem, you can see. So what is embryo? Embryo is the tiny structure at the base of the seed leaves. Okay. These are the leaf like structure, and this one is known as embryo. Okay. Seedlings develop from this embryo. The young plant grows from this embryo. Okay. Embryo contain two parts. One is radicle and the another one is plumule. Okay. Now see here, this complete portion is embryo, so it contains two parts. See here, these two leaf like structure. So one will grow as radicle and another will grow as plumule. Okay. So radicle part grows downside and it develops into root after the germination of seed. Okay. And plumule part, it grows upward outside the soil and grows into shoot after the process of germination. Then the next part is cotyledons. Now what are cotyledons? Cotyledons are the special structures which are present in the seed. Okay. And these cotyledons are responsible for surrounding the embryo. Here it is embryo. So these embryo are surrounded by the cotyledons. Cotyledons are also called as seed leaves. These are called as leaves, seed leaves. Okay. Why? Now, why the cotyledons are called as seed leaves? Because this cotyledons, they comes after germination when shoot arise, when shoot comes out of the soil, then these cotyledons will arise as the first leaves of the plant. Okay. On the basis of the number of cotyledons. Now, see, in this seed, you are going to observe two cotyledons and here there is only one cotyledon. See, this green structure, it is the cotyledon. Okay. So, on the basis of the number of cotyledons, seed are of two types. Monocot seed and dicot seed. So, whenever the cotyledon is one or single in a seed, then that seed is known as monocot seed. And when the number of cotyledon in a seed is two, or then it is known as dicot seed. Okay. And if it is more than two, then it is called as multicot. Okay. But usually it is called as dicot and monocot. Examples of monocot seeds are maize. Okay. Maize, all the cereals are monocot seed. Cereals means wheat, rice, maize, they all are monocot seeds. And dicot, example of dicot seeds are bean. Okay, beans, your rajma, chawla, okay, gram seeds, peas, they all are dicot seed. Have you ever observed your mothers are soaking gram seeds and rajma and chawla in the night, and in the morning when you are going to push that seed in between two fingers, then it will split or it breaks into two parts. Why? Because of the presence of two cotyledons. Okay, that's why it is known as dicot seed. Then the last part is the endosperm. Endosperm occupies the major part of the seed. You can observe here in this monocot seed, the maximum part of the seed is occupied by endosperm. Endosperm is the reserve food of the embryo. Usually endosperm is more developed in monocot seed. Okay. And in dicot seed, cotyledons are more developed and endosperm is reduced or suppressed. Okay. Got it. So here the cotyledons, they are going to store food for the embryo in the dicot seed, because here endosperm is reduced. But in the monocot seed, endosperm act for the reservation of the food and cotyledons is somewhat reduced. Got it? So this is the part of a seed. Now The next topic is germination of a seed. First of all, let me explain you what is germination. Germination is a process by which seed grows into young plant or baby plant called as seedling. Okay, so on the arrival of favorable condition, when a seed grows into a young plant or seedling, then the process is known as germination. Now, for the germination of seed, there are certain essential conditions required. Okay, and for that, three conditions are very essential, and these are water, sunlight, and air. Okay, so water, sunlight, and air are the necessary conditions for the germination of a seed. Now, what happens is, let us talk about water. During germination, as I told you, the outermost layer, seed coat, absorbs water. Okay, due to the absorption of water by the seed start growing in size. As a result, the seed coat becomes soft, so it bursts. Okay, the seed coat bursts and the seed opens. Okay, along with that, the water, it changes the stored food inside the seed into soluble form, and that soluble food is utilized by the developing embryo for its growth. Got it? Then the next one is sunlight. As you know that plants, they are going to perform the process of photosynthesis for their food requirement. So sunlight and air, these are required for the process of photosynthesis. Oxygen, which is present in the air. Okay, this air, it contains oxygen. So this oxygen is utilized for the process of respiration also by the developing embryo. And the energy which is released as the result of respiration. Okay, this energy is used by embryo for its growth into seedling. Got it? Sunlight and air, they are utilized for the process of photosynthesis. Along with that, air also contains oxygen. So oxygen is utilized for the respiration of the embryo also. And you know that there is evolution of energy in the process of respiration. So this energy is utilized by the embryo inside the seed for its growth into seedling. Clear? Along with that, this water and oxygen, they are helping in activation of the enzymes which are present in the cotyledons. Okay, and these enzymes, they helps in the digestion of the stored food which is present in the cotyledons, and as a result, again, there is evolution of energy which is utilized by the embryo to grow into a new plant. Okay, so when all such conditions are there, then the two leaves or the two leaves of the embryo, okay, that is the radicle, okay, it grows down into the soil to form the root of the new plant, and the plumule, it grows upside and forms the shoot of the plant, and the cotyledons, they dried and fall off. Okay, now there is another condition which is required for the germination also, and it is temperature, but it is not taken as essential condition, but temperature matters a lot. So for the germination of a seed, the optimum temperature required is in between the range of 15 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius. Now, as you know that there are two types of seed, monocot and dicot, and there are different they also differ on the basis of their structure and all that. Now, what happens is, different types of seeds, they can go to different ways by which seeds germinate, and the types of seed germination are epigeal germination and hypogeal germination. Now, I'll explain you apogeal and hypogeal germination with the help of this diagram. Look here in this diagram, apogeal germination. Apogeal germination most commonly observed in dicot C. Okay. And in this type of germination, the cotyledons comes out of the soil. And the cotyledons provide or fulfill the food requirement of the developing embryo till the first leaves comes out or arise. And more than one or two days, then after that the cotyledons, they dried up and they fall. Got it? Are you observing the diagram? See, this is the seed, dicot seed or bean seed. So what happens is, here you know that radical develops into which part? Radical develops into root, and plumule develops into shoot. So what happens is, the first part which is attached to the cotyledon is of the plumule is known as hypocotyle. Okay, means the part of the plumule, it start growing in size and it comes out. And as it comes out, then it pulls the cotyledon outside the soil, and the cotyledons comes out. Clear? So what happens is, the cotyledons, then they comes out in the form of a first pair of the leaf here. Okay, and this cotyledon, it provides nourishment to the developing seedling. And after that, this cotyledon, it dries and fall down. Okay, and then what happens? The plant will grow in size. And then here, the radical, it will result in the formation of root system of the plant. So what you have to remember is, in the apogeal germination, the cotyledon comes out of the soil and provide food for the growing seedling for 2 or 3 days, and then afterward it dried and fall off. And it is most commonly observed in the dicot seed. Second type of germination is hypogeal germination. Here is the diagram which shows hypogeal germination. In hypogeal germination, the cotyledons remain inside the soil and they will never come out of the soil. Got it? In apogeal, the cotyledon comes out, but here the cotyledons, they remain inside the soil. They will never come up. The plumule grows into shoot, and the radical develops into root, and plumule grows into shoot, and after that the cotyledon disintegrate here inside the soil only. Clear? And hypogeal type of germination is most commonly observed in monocot seed, example maize. Got it? So apogeal germination, the cotyledon comes out of the soil, and hypogeal germination is where the cotyledon remain inside the soil. It will never come up, and it will nourish the plant till the first pair, which are capable of doing photosynthesis, comes out. Till then, the cotyledon nourish the seedling, and after that it dried and disintegrate inside the soil only. So this is the end of your today's class, and with this we have finished with your chapter number 1, that is plant life. So you can go for question and answers, short questions and detailed questions, which I will provide you in a link just given below this video. In the details of the video, a link is provided to you, so you have to see to it, and in that I will provide you short and detailed question and answer. And with this, we will finish with the we have finished with the first chapter of your book. Then in the next video class, we'll start with the second chapter, that is the cell. So, enjoy your day. Take care.